Hello everyone, welcome to the part 1 of the video where I'll show you guys how to make your own PSP theme. But before starting to work on theme, I think it's important to understand what the different components of a PDF theme are. So starting off with the first component, we have the preview icon. The preview icons are these small icons which has a size of 16 by 16 pixels. It's a 32-bit color image and can have the formats TGA, PNG or GAM. The very next component is the preview image. The preview image has a size of 300 by 170 pixels and it needs to be a 24-bit direct color image and needs to be in the BMP format. The next major part of any PSP theme is the category icons. They are the main icons and have a size of 64 by 48 pixels. They are 32-bit color image and can be of the formats TGA, PNG or GIM. There are a total of 6 category icons. Alright, so the next part is the first level icons and their focuses. So the first level icons are those icons that are situated above and below the category icons. They are of the size 48 by 48 pixels, are 32-bit color images and can have the formats TGA, PNG and GIM. And there are a total of 24 first level icons. Also, every first level icons needs to have its own focus, which is the image that flashes behind them. So the next component is the second level icons, having a size of 32 by 32 pixels. They are also 32-bit color images and can have the formats TGA, PNG and GAM. Also, the second level icon also has a focus. And the last and the final component of a theme is its wallpaper. So the wallpaper is a BMP image having the size 480 by 272 pixels. It also needs to be a 24-bit direct color image. And these are pretty much all the components of a PSP PDF theme. Now, when it comes to making a theme, the first thing we need to do is to acquire the images to use as a wallpaper and icons. I think Google would be your best friend to download them. And by the way, try to find images of the PNG format as they can be worked on easily. So once all the images have been downloaded, the next thing I'm going to do is to edit them. You could skip this step if you want to as it's not compulsory or anything. So for the editing, I have used a couple of different editing softwares such as Adobe, Photoshop, Paint3D, PixArt, etc. Once the editing is done, the next thing to do is to convert the images into the before mentioned sizes and formats. But before doing this, it would be better if you'd just organize all the images into different folders based on their uses. So I have already organized the first level icons and their focuses into a folder, and I'm gonna do the same for the rest of the images. Once that's done, we can proceed with the converting these images to the required format. Now, there are many ways to do this, but the easiest way I've seen is to use the application called CTF Tool GUI. You can download it by going to the link down in the description. So once the download is complete, go back to your downloads folder and extract the file. After the extraction, run the application for the first time as an administrator. You can close it after making it run for the first time. Now, every time you right click on an image and then go to the show more option, you will find a new option called the CTF tool menu. From here, you can simply convert any images to the formats required to make a theme with the help of a simple click. Once you convert an image, you could either delete the original file or you could move them to a separate folder for future use. I personally like to keep all the original files in a separate folder as I could access them in the future if I want to. So now, as you can see, the first level icons and the focuses are ready, but their file names right now are really confusing, so I'm renaming each and every one of them so that way I could know which ones are which. Now we have pretty much converted all the images. Now the only thing that's left to do is to turn them into a theme, which I will show you guys in the next video. Till then, thank you everyone for watching, and make sure to subscribe to the channel for more awesome PSP content.